We are beginning a unit on chemical reactions, so it's important for us to be able to tell when a reaction has taken place. Every time two substances are mixed together, that does not necessarily mean that a chemical reaction has taken place. The only true way to tell is to run some kind of analytical test, which we don't always have access to. So there are some things that we can look out for that will indicate that a reaction has taken place. The most common indicators of chemical change are color change, temperature change, emitting light, the formation of a gas, and you would recognize this through bubbles. If you were to mix two things together and bubbles formed, that would indicate that a reaction has taken place. And then the last common indicator is the formation of a precipitate. A precipitate is a solid that forms during a chemical reaction. So imagine you pour two liquids together and a thick, cloudy substance starts to form and settle out at the bottom. That would be a precipitate. So these are the indicators of chemical change to help you recognize when a reaction has taken place. Once you have determined that a chemical reaction is taking place, the next step is to try to figure out what is being produced. Start by looking at your reactants. What substances did you put together to form the chemical reaction? And try to predict what substances you are going to produce. Then product testing comes into play. Product testing are simple tests that you can run to see if certain chemicals are being produced by a reaction. We're going to focus on product testing for three gases. The first one is hydrogen. So if a chemical reaction is being run in a test tube and hydrogen is being produced, you can take a burning splint, so I mean a piece of wood that you have lit on fire, that is a burning splint, and put it down into the test tube. If hydrogen is being produced by that test tube, you will hear a very distinct popping sound. It is like a miniature explosion taking place from the hydrogen, because hydrogen is a flammable gas. It only happens once. It's a very quick, very distinct popping sound. So the product test for hydrogen is to put a burning splint into a test tube and listen for a popping sound. The popping sound confirms that hydrogen is being produced. The lack of a popping sound would indicate that some other gas is being produced. The next product test is for oxygen. So if you have a test tube where you think oxygen is being produced, this product test will confirm that. Start with a glowing splint. So this is a splint that you caught on fire, but then you blew out the fire and it's still really hot and it is glowing. If you put a glowing splint into a test tube where oxygen is being produced, the flame will reignite because oxygen is one of the things that helps a flame burn. So the product test for oxygen is to put a glowing splint into a test tube. If the flame reignites, that is confirmation that oxygen is being produced. The final test is for carbon dioxide. The product test for carbon dioxide is to bubble it through lime water. Lime water is the common name for calcium hydroxide, and it is a clear substance. So you start with a clear liquid of lime water. If you bubble carbon dioxide through it, the solution will turn cloudy, and that is confirmation that your reaction is producing carbon dioxide. I will mention that the setup for this product test would be a little more complicated in that you would have a flask where the reaction was being run, and the flask would have a tube in it, and the tube would need to go down into the lime water. So the product test for carbon dioxide is to bubble it through lime water. If the solution turns cloudy, you are very likely producing carbon dioxide by your chemical reaction. Product testing is a great way to help you figure out what is being produced by your chemical reaction. Stick around as we start to look at how you can take all of that information and put it into a chemical equation.